Both sides squared off today over Proposition 23, the voter initiative, which suspends some air pollution control laws.
KCRA3's Lindsay Paula shows us why this debate is not just about air quality, it's also about jobs.
What do we want?
Jobs now!
What do we want?
The Howard Jarvis Taxpayers Association and Northern California Tea Party marched in front of the California Air Resources Board building today. They're supporting Proposition 23, which would suspend some air pollution control laws until state unemployment drops below 5.5%.
I own a truck fleet, and they're trying to put us out of business, basically, you know, trying to have us replace our trucks when there's no money.
A vote for Prop 23 is a vote for jobs and California families.
Prop 23 supporters say it's not anti-environment, it's pro-jobs. But opponents strongly disagree. Sacramento Mayor Kevin Johnson, the Sacramento Air Quality Management District, and SMUD say 23 will increase pollution and hurt the green jobs economy.
We're here because we do not support Proposition 23. It's clear we have a goal with GreenWise. We want to be the greenest region in the country and a hub for clean technology. This proposition will not allow that to happen.
Mark Newton with the Legislative Analyst's Office says a nonpartisan analysis of 23's impacts show a modest uptick in the economy from suspending some climate change regulations. As for jobs,
we think that the overall net impact on jobs is fairly modest. Could be slightly positive from the measure, but not large.
And the LAO says it could be 5 years or more before unemployment figures drop enough to allow those climate change laws to go back into effect. In Sacramento, Lindsay Paulo, KCRA 3 reports.
And the Legislative Analyst's Office says in the last 40 years, there have been three times when unemployment dropped below 5.5% for at least four quarters, which is what Proposition 23 would require.